Hello and welcome. My name's Peter Holloway. I'm one of the elders here at CBC. I trust that God will bless us as we seek his face together, as we lift our hearts in worship together and seek to know him better. First thing we're going to do is we're going to read a verse of scripture together. Please do read it aloud with me. It's from Hebrews chapter 4 and it's verse 16. Let us then approach God's throne of grace with confidence, so that we may receive mercy and find grace to help us in our time of need. Let's commit our time to the Lord in prayer. Our Lord God and our Heavenly Father, we want to thank you for our great salvation. We want to thank you for the privilege of being able to come to you to receive mercy and to find grace in our time of need. We confess, Heavenly Father, that we are in need of you more than anything else. And we ask that by your Spirit now that you would help us to worship you, to lift our hearts to you, to do so in a manner that is worthy of who you are, that honours you and your most holy name. Lord God, help us to fix our eyes on you, on Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith. And help us also to learn from you as we lift our hearts to you and seek your face together. Amen. We're going to continue our worship time now by singing together. The song that we're going to sing is Come, O Fount of Every Blessing. Let's prayerfully, as we sing it, seek that God would tune our hearts to sing his grace. Let's sing.
Of every blessing, tune my heart to sing your grace. Streams of mercy never ceasing, call for songs of loudest praise. Songs of God's abundant treasure, sung by angel times above. Songs that tell the boundless treasure of my Lord's unchanging love. I remember God's great mercy, by his help I safely come, and I know he will not fail me, but will surely sought me when a stranger, wandering far away from God, and to rescue me from danger, shed for me his precious blood. Through God's grace I am his debtor, daily Lord, like a fetter, bind my wandering heart to you. Prone to wander, Lord, I feel it, prone to leave the God I love. Take my heart, Lord, take and seal it, seal it from your courts above.
See your love. Well, we want to be encouraging each other to read good books, and so I've asked Caro to talk about a book that she's read recently. Caro, tell us about a book that you've been reading recently.
Well, I have one here. I have been reading Fruitfulness on the Frontline by Mark Green.
What's its kind of big message?
Its tagline is talking about making a difference where you are. And it's basically looking at how God can and does use us in whatever situation we're in, wherever we might be living. And in those natural conversations and situations that would arise each day whilst we're living on our front line.
Is there a particular part of the book or particular thought in the book that you found particularly helpful?
Yeah, so various things. It's encouraging and it's practical. It's split into sort of three main sections, which delve around the idea of fruitfulness and about how we can be fruitful in our everyday living. So it looks at the foundations of fruitfulness and then gives us frameworks with which we can apply fruitfulness into our everyday life and then look at how we can grow ourselves as well. I have struggled previously to find a book that is predominantly evangelism based that doesn't leave me feeling lacking.
And guilty.
Mark Green, he's really warm and he's encouraging. I like the practical aspects. He uses real life stories of people he's met. He uses situations that he's been in himself. And a lot of the work that he does revolves around seminars and sort of focus groups that he'd had to come up with these various ideas about how people could naturally sort of engage with people within their community, their workplace, or whatever your front line might actually be.
Great. So I guess the idea is that not everyone's front line is the same. Everyone's got their own context, their own overlapping relationships. Everyone's front line looks different, and it's how to do it's thinking about evangelism not in someone else's front line but in your own.
Yeah, completely. There was a good quote actually that I think really sort of kicked off to the book appealing for to me. And it basically said that this book, it's not an exhortation to become like anybody else, not to become someone that you're not, although there is much to learn from others. Rather, it's an encouragement, I hope, to grow more alert to the ways that the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ has been working, is working, might work in and through you right where you are, whatever your front line. I also think it's the sort of book that you'd be able to read over and over again at different sort of stages of your life. So my stage of life at the moment, sort of being at home with Sam and that sort of school run and various things like that is a different front line to something that I might have in 2 years' time or 5 years' time. So it's good. It's something that you can go and revisit that will be relevant to whatever the situation is, because it's actually about finding the relevant situation that you're in.
Fantastic. So who might you recommend this book to?
That's a good question. I think I would recommend it to people who are struggling to know where they might be able to make a difference. People who feel that perhaps they are maybe not lacking in an area, but they don't feel confident or comfortable in engaging with other people or starting conversations. And also perhaps people who feel maybe a bit dispirited that they're not making a difference, because actually they are. And I think that's what's great about this, that it shows that wherever you are, you absolutely are making a difference.
Before we pray, we're going to read some verses from Hebrews chapter 4, verses 14 to 16. Therefore, since we have a great high priest who has ascended into heaven, Jesus, the Son of God, let us hold firmly to the faith we profess. For we do not have a high priest who is unable to feel sympathy for our weaknesses, but we have one who has been tempted in every way, just as we are, yet he did not sin. Let us then approach God's throne of grace with confidence, so that we may receive mercy and find grace to help us in our time of need.
Well, let's turn to God in prayer now. Let's pray. Our Heavenly Father, we want to praise you that we have such a great High Priest, one who has ascended into heaven, Jesus, the Son of God. Lord God, we do hold firmly to that faith in Jesus Christ that we confess. Lord God, we praise you that Jesus knows us inside out, that he understands us, he understands our weaknesses, and yet he himself is sinless. Lord God, we thank you that we can approach your throne of grace with confidence, with boldness. And Father, thank you that in approaching you, we will receive mercy, we will find grace to help us in our time of need. Father, we want to thank you that in Jesus Christ we have salvation. We have redemption through his blood. Lord, we thank you that in that redemption we now are the body of Christ, his people, that we belong to you, we're the sheep of your pasture. Lord God, we want to thank you for the hope that we have of Jesus' return for us, his people, for his consummation of all his plans and purposes in this world and in the world to come. Father, we thank you that Jesus Christ is our hope of glory. Lord God, we acknowledge first and foremost our need of you. We confess our pride in our own ability to live our life without you. We confess our daily failure in word and in deed. We confess our failure to do what we should and our failure not to do what we should not. Lord, we ask that you would forgive us. Father, as we look around this world in which we live, we see confusion. Lord, we don't know which way to turn. Father, we see the global pandemic. We see the turmoil over the death of a man in America. Lord, we realise that this world is fallen and lost without you. Lord God, we pray that you would have mercy in this world. Father, we pray that you would have mercy in all nations in the light of what we see around us. Lord, we pray that you would have mercy in particular on those who are persecuted for their faith around the world. Father, we appreciate that where we live, that we are able to freely speak of you, freely worship you, freely lift up our hearts to you. And yet we understand that around the world, those who name the name of Jesus are suffering for their faith. Lord, we pray for your grace to them. Father, we pray for our own current situation. We pray for ourselves for strength and for comfort during this lockdown. Father, we pray that you would help us to fix our eyes on you, to seek your strength and to find in you the peace that only you can give. Lord God, we pray for our government. We pray that you would give them wisdom and insight, give them courage to stand fast to what needs to be done. Father, we pray for all of government together, that they would stand together for the best of this country. Father, we pray for those working in the front line who have to go out to help in one way or another, and we pray for your protection for them. Lord God, we pray for those who are struggling, whether it be financially, socially, mentally, or with this COVID virus. Lord, we pray for your help. But Lord God, what we pray for most of all is that people would turn to the Lord Jesus Christ. Father, we realise that we don't get out of this world alive, but one day we will face you, our Lord and our God. And we thank you for Jesus. We thank you for the hope that we have. And what we have, we pray, would shine as a light to all those around us who are lost without Jesus. Lord, we pray that you would save souls. We pray for our own church, Lord God. We pray particularly for Mike Jourdain. We thank you for bringing him through the surgery safely. Lord, we pray for the chemo that he has to face over the coming weeks. Lord God, we pray that you give him physical strength, spiritual strength, emotional strength. We pray for Mike and Wendy, for Cleo, for Lloyd. Lord, we pray that you would bless them and strengthen them and uphold them as only you can do. Father, we thank you for Joel Upton's safe return home. Lord, we rejoice that he is back with his family. Father, we pray that you continue to strengthen him. We pray that the procedure that he had would keep him safe and healthy. And Lord, again, we thank you for your grace. Lord, we thank you for the opportunities that we're having as a church, even in lockdown. We thank you for the Christianity Explored course. We thank you for the privilege of meeting together via Zoom. Lord, we pray that in these strange and difficult times, that by your Spirit you would encourage us, upbuild us, help us to know more about who you are. And for those in particular who are inquiring as to what Christianity is all about, Lord God, we pray that you would open their eyes, help them to see the wonders of who you are. And lastly, Heavenly Father, we pray that as we seek to hear from you through your word, we ask that you'd speak to us. We ask that you'd open our eyes, encourage our hearts, draw us to yourself, we ask. And Lord, may your kingdom come and your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Lord, we ask all these things in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Well, before we hear from God's word, we're going to sing again. The song we're going to sing asks the question, depth of mercy. Can there be mercy still reserved for me? And of course, the answer for those who believe is that all mercy comes from the Lord Jesus Christ to us. Let's sing together.
Death of mercy, can there be mercy still reserved for me? Can my God, his wrath forbear me, the chief of sinners spare? I have long withstood his grace, long provoked him to his face, would not listen to his calls, grieved him by a thousand fold. Why to me this waste of love? Ask my advocate above, see the cause in Jesus' face, there before the throne of grace. There for me my Saviour stands.